It is June 9th, 2015, and I'm Mary Pryor. I go by Gina, part of my middle name. And this is to document the financial crimes that certain members of my family have committed against me to take control of my assets, including my home, and trying to liquidate them. And they have a cover story that they have lied to me and lied about me for now several years, and I've just recently found out, and I do need assistance. I have the evidence of what has been done to me, including the false evidence that was filed against me in a forcible detainer hearing. I have a certified court order from the U.S. District Court, Northern Region of Texas, Dallas Division, of Chief Justice Sidney Fitzwater. I had that order certified in the clerk's office, that said that there was no foreclosure on my home, which is what I said all along. This was not the evidence. The evidence that the opposing party was presenting always said that there was a foreclosure, and they were lying. They presented false evidence in that civil lawsuit, and also in the forcible detainer one. I don't believe that the people that were representing them, it was supposedly HWA that is down in Houston, but since I never saw any of these attorneys in person, and they never came to Dallas for any of these motions or hearings, then it's possible that it was all lies and set up what you call organized gang stalking to try to make the victim to believe things took place that really didn't. That's probably the only way that they could get away with presenting false evidence multiple times. And also for 2 years, the property tax for my home was paid for from an escrow account in my name, according to the IRS and according to the property tax rolls. And there have been false documents that have been filed against my home, but they're fraudulent. And I've tried to let certain officials know that they were fraudulent, but when I tried to go to present my evidence, what ends up happening is I will talk to the receptionist for whatever organization or agency that I'm trying to talk to, and the people that end up coming to see me to talk to me, it takes a long time. It may take almost an hour before somebody shows up. But they come from the public elevator, or they come from a hallway leading from outside. They could be literally anyone, and they do not appear to be the people that they're saying that they are, or the position that they're trying to represent. I've also had this happen with in people impersonating Dallas police officers. This happened a couple of times where it appears that they've gotten real squad cars, which I believe that they must have bribed the maintenance area, and they've gotten these that have been out of service for maintenance. Is the only way that I can think of that they've gotten these vehicles, but they don't have a card They never present a picture ID, and things concerning their uniform are not right. They're faded, or they have the wrong there's problems with their uniforms. And it's obvious that they're not a real Dallas police officer. So this actually does happen. It's happened more than once to me. And I just want to document that. And I appreciate you listening. If anybody can, I'm a resident of Dallas, Texas, and have been for most of my life. Except for about 13 months that I lived in another state, but other than that. And like I said, I have evidence concerning what has been done to me. Thank you very much for listening.